Landing at the capital, Sofia, we drive 150 kilometers southwards to Bansko, at the heart of the Pirin Mountains, which will be our base for the next 3 nights. Our first 3 nights was based at the Molarite Hotel, Bansko. Our first day's trekking involves ascending to the Todorina Porta Pass at 2,500 meters.
Main god called Pirin, and they said that their main god lived here on the mountain side of this mountain. So the mountain was called the Mountain of Pirin or Pirin, and afterwards in the centuries it changed from Pirin to Pirin. So it's the home of the Slavic god. Beautiful mountain in the world, Pirin is regarded like this. On Pirin we have 18 plant species, vascular plants, which are local endemics. So you can only see them here, nowhere else in the world, only on this very restricted territory. We have the forests are very interesting, pristine forests, 90% of the forests here on the mountainside on the national park territory never touched by man. Most of them formed by endemic species again, Macedonian and Bosnian pine, which are Balkan endemics, not only in Pirin but on the Balkan Peninsula. Golden eagle, which is the biggest one with wings spread 40 centimeters at least, more than my hands. Actually, the Griffon Vulture is the biggest. The Griffon Vulture just returned back to Pirin Mountain a few years ago, and it's the biggest with a wing spread of 2 meters and 20. My arms are 170 like this, and you can imagine 220, quite a big bird. Going down to the fire crest that big, or the gold crest, birds that... A lot of mammals here, the bear we already mentioned a few times, it's waiting for us there around the corner. It's the biggest mammal, but we have red and roe deers, we have the Balkan chamois, which is a Balkan endemic species again, it's a subspecies of the Alpine chamois. We'll be able to see some of these chamois, the mountain goats, our high alpine goats here on the mountainside.
Ready to go?
Yeah. Yeah.
We all here? Okay, let's do it.
Valu is offering you a ride back if you're reconsidering. Haide, Valu, ciao, tu vă vezi.
We take the forest trail following the Demyanitsa River until we reach the Demyanitsa mountain hut at 1,895 meters. The Pirin Mountains spans a territory of just under 1,000 square miles and is host to over 100 glacial layers. It is noted for its rich flora and fauna, and much of the area is forested with conifer, Macedonian and Bosnian pine, and fir. Demyanitsa Mountain Hut, at just under 1900 metres, accommodates 170 people in its main hut and its surrounding wooden bungalows. The Pirin is home to 2,000 species of plants, including the Pirin poppy, indigenous just to the Pirin area.
The hiker's dream, because the leaves are very suitable if you don't have the toilet paper. They brought, they're soft, and they do a good job.
After a long steady climb, we reached the Vasilashki Lakes.
And then we come in again a bit to the left to cross the ridge. Actually, this is the ridge of Tudorka, and we have to cross this ridge to descend the other valley at the other side. Point, it's a bit to the right from here. And the lake name, a popular name in Bulgaria, because there used to be a shepherd in the past living here in this area, and his name was Vasil.
One of the Vasilashki lakes is Tudora's eyes. Legend has it that a local girl named Tudorka was refused by her father to marry her beloved Vasil. So she ran away from home, reached the peak and cried. And this is how the two lakes, Todorinoki, were formed. Vasil searched for her in vain and in the end threw himself in despair from the nearby peak into the lake below. From the Todorina Porta, we descend steeply passing the Bundarishki Lakes to the Viren Hut, where hopefully our minibus awaits. Vladimir set a good pace which kept us moving and keeping together, and at our rest stops who would always keep us informed of the flora and fauna and geology and history of the area.
The fish lake just behind us there, and we continue further down to the mountain hut of Pirin, which is situated here. A sharp turn at the other side of the village, under the north face of the sun.
Any comments, Roy?
No comments.
Thought somebody might have said, the end.
After 7 hours of trekking, we finally reached the Viren hut. And yes, our minibus is waiting to take us back to Bansko. Bansko is the largest ski resort in the Balkans, at the foot of the Pirin National Park. Its name is derived from the Hebrew, those who are keepers of the mountain. In the summer, the town is popular for climbers and trekkers alike. Its cobbled streets are lined with fine houses and restaurants, some dating back to the early 19th century. The Church of St. Trinity is the largest in the region. Completed in 1835, is an Orthodox Christian church.
Are you ready?
Yeah, you can see the stork nest there. The storks should be there now.
It's survival. It's improving its survival skills.
На здраве!
На здраве!
Glass is up with you, it's for a good picture. На здраве! Hey, well done there!
After exploring the Pirin Mountains, we travel northwards to the Rila Mountains. And firstly, we visit the 1,000-year-old Rila Monastery.
We can go in.
At just over 1,000 meters, hugged amidst an old coniferous forest is the greatest monastery in Bulgaria. Its rise is related to the hermit Ivan Rilski, who as a youth was disillusioned by the decline of morals, so he joined the monkhood and retired into the mountains to live in a cave. He is now the patron saint of Bulgaria.
The origin of the name is Thracian, Aprila. Before the Slavic people came, the Thracians were living here in the area, and they named the mountain Rola, which literally translated should mean the water mountain. So you can see the water mountain. And under the clearance, you see the main church of the monastery. This is one of the most popular churches in Bulgaria. It's a typical Orthodox Christian church. In Bulgaria, we are Christians, Orthodox Christians. Most of us, more than 90%, less than 90%, 80%. 200 monasteries in the country. So this is the biggest of them, and this is definitely the most prominent one. Saint Ivan. Some will translate in English like John, but it's not a John. It's not John. He's regarded like the founder of the monastery. During his lifetime, he was not really participating actively in establishing the monastery, but he was... He tried, but then it changed a bit. But he became, anyway, the leader of this monk society around. It's one of the most popular tourist attractions in Bulgaria as well. In the whole of Bulgaria, it gets a few million visitors every year. It has around 60 monks living in the monastery these days. And the church is a typical Orthodox church. These murals, so these frescoes, are depicting scenes from the Bible. So, for example, you can see they are left from the door. That depiction should be the door to the paradise. And Saint did the holding a key. You don't see the key right now, but in a hand he is holding a key. Right now we are on the territory of a reserve, which is called Rila Monastery Forest Reserve. It was established because of the forest. The forest around is really interesting. It's it's a mixed forest, a mixed broadleaves and conifer trees, and it's a very diverse one. We have more than 25 different tree species only. We have sycamores, we have English, okay, acacia species. And at least, not at least, but exactly 5 different conifer species in the area. So a lot of different species, and many more, of course. A lot of...
Everywhere's flat, but we can't make
it. Saint Ivan of Rila, that's the founder of the monastery. That's the man who came to live like a hermit here on the mountainside. That's why you see him like this depicted in front of a cave on the mountainside. Actually, he lived in a small cave, and right now we are going to visit the cave. So that's what we are going to do, visit his grave and then continue the way down to the monastery. Basically, we follow in a centuries-old pilgrim's route, but we're doing it the other way around. The people in the past would do it from the monastery to here, and then back. The place where Saint Ivan of Rila lived here in the end of 9th, beginning of 10th century. Like a hermit, he was living in a little cave just behind the present chapel here. He was a famous healer and a famous wise man. Actually, he was called Saint Ivan the Wonder Maker as well, because he was performing wonders or miracles, the miracle maker. Yeah. But first we take a look at the grave and the chapel. That's the entrance of the cave here. When you enter, you have to be careful because it's very low. So mind your head here, going up the stairs.
We've got our shots here.
And the cave is that big, is nothing special, just a small cave. But it's very handy if you have a second entrance or a hole leading up like there. You can see there. That's what. Okay, let's do it one by one. Here are some steps here.
Little narrow steps to go up.
And the cave is really famous in Bulgaria. Many people will come here for the cave as well. So this spring is regarded holy water because it's the spring which the saint used to drink from when he was living here like a hermit. The spring of Saint Ivan of Rila. You see here. Many chapels and other buildings scattered along the hills around. As you can see an example of this here. We have two chapels here. This one is called the Shroud of the Virgin.
The hills are alive with the sound of Marcus.
Tonight we stay one night in the Rilska Rika Valley, near to the Rila Monastery. We begin our next day's trek from the monastery, where we start our panoramic hike through the heart of the Rila Mountains. Preparations on the way for our long steep ascent through forests, passing many meadows and then up and over one of the highest and most imposing ridge, the Boshia Ridge, where we will have spectacular views of the seven Rila lakes.
The
that in. The howl of the
We have climbed about 250 meters on the coast here. I just
just another 3,000 metres to go.
It's not that much, I think it's 900.
On the main ridge of the mountain, this part of the mountain. Actually, we are on the main water divide on the mountains as well. And when it was raining 1 hour ago, the drop that fell down there 1 meter from me will go to the Black Sea, to the north, and then to the Black Sea. The drops that fell down where Marcus is staying will go down this way to the Aegean Sea. So the main water divide is passing here on the whole Balkan Peninsula. And it's one of the highest ridges in Rila Mountain. And we've done all our ascent, 1,400 meters up to here. So far, so good. Okay. We have 1,000 meters of descent first, and some more walking.
So the ascent today is 1,500
meters,
is it?
yeah, it's something like 1,500, yeah.
Ah.
Although it was impossible to view all seven lakes, through a temporary cloud break, we did manage to see one. Now we descend 1,000 meters, following the green ridge to the Malyovitska Valley. Today was our longest and toughest day, covering 22 kilometres, or 14 miles, and gaining an altitude of 1,400 metres. Our final 400 metre ascent is just what the doctor ordered. This time we stay two nights in the family-run hotel in Govardhatsi. Georgian family was so welcoming, serving traditional cuisine which was excellent, not to mention the excellent beer.
This potato soup is probably the best of our holiday so far.
Even the bowl.
Yeah.
There's Jack, he's always on time. Not.
More than,
I'm
early by about
5 minutes.
Really?
Different.
Is that?
Royal Marine.
Good driver? Yeah. Cheers.
Is that a cycling top? Is it gone?
No, yeah, it's good for cycling, but it's from a running competition. I don't do much cycling.
But you've just been on the way up slightly
more because
I don't think there's many of the one Louis introduced us to because we thought we got an actor.
Have you?
Oh, the white.
Roy's now tucking into his stuffed pepper. Oh, the light's gone out as well. Well, it looks better now. You see what it is.
Then first terrace, second terrace here where the blue is joining the red. And we continued on the red to the end of the valley, then the steep ascent to the lake. We continued here to the black point, which is the summit actually.
Our evening's performance was some traditional folk singing, with Georgie's father playing the harmonica. Georgie's wife was quite persuasive in forming a dance group and led the dancers outside.
We're all joining in.
So it's our final day's breakfast. It's Friday, whatever date. Breakfast consists of a running buffet.
Banana.
So what are we having here, Marcus?
Cut on the name and stuff.
Yeah. It's yellow pastry with cheese and maybe spinach.
Oh, yeah,
there we go.
Yeah, let's put that piece here.
I think
it's going to be sour to me. Excuse fingers. Who wants it? They're my fingers.
Yeah. You did all that work.
This is just like a council building site. One of them's doing the work and about 30 of us watching.
Exactly. Tea break now.
I'm sure you're right, actually. I think I was being a bit restrained. Okay, actually not.
Our final trekking day is ascending Bulgaria's highest mountain, Musala, at 2,925 metres, or 9,500 feet.
Let's see these magic sticks of yours. You going to take them all the way? Okay, well, it's been recorded what you just said. Okay, so we'll see.
Okay, there's a bit of cheating going on at first. As we ascend by gondola from Borovet to our start at 2,300 metres.
Here we're going. We're going on the gondola first. The clouds.
Yeah. The view's up to here. I hope it will move away later, but we will see.
It's coming. There's one coming.
Then the clouds we all clear out and we go on the summit in excellent view conditions.
Chance. Well, come on, you just have to raise your sticks and do some magic and make the cloud go away.
Yeah, you get these two magic sticks.
Slam it down. Clouds move.
I thought it was fall forward.
Both seem very comfy, Both slightly different.
Yeah. Oh yeah.
That's the shallow then.
Yeah, it's
And it's not sure for them that they will survive, depending on how the weather will develop in the next few weeks, because all the water might evaporate before they are developed, you know.
Well, if we stay here, they'll probably drown.
With the first mountain hut here in the area from the 20s, the 20th century, and then later on, I think in the 50s, the other one was built, the big one on top of it. But it's under construction right now because it was hit by lightning in the 70s. It was hit by lightning and set on fire, this one. They said, okay, we built this one behind us, just like a temporary hut for a few years until we reconstruct this one. And these few years are more than 40 years now. Yeah. This is the hut. And they started reconstructing this 2 years ago, but doing it very slowly, as you can see. Built and finished 2 years ago, but after they built it, they discovered that it's not really clever done. They do not have the needed water supply for it. And now it's because of this, it's still not open. They plan to open it this year, but still they have troubles of having water because it's not that much here in the area. It's quite high on the mountain side. So you see a lot of mountain huts, a big mess of mountain huts here.
Yeah.
That's the functioning one behind us. And these are the Musala lakes. There are two lakes here in front of us, Musala lakes. And the summit is actually over there in the mist, behind the first ridge on the second one. You want me to tell you?
What is it?
It's the Sphinx. Like the Sphinx is in front of the pyramids in Egypt. So we have a Sphinx here. Brought it from Egypt up to the ridge there.
And then by a few lakes up to the highest one, the Icy Lake, and from there to the summit.
Hey!
So well done, everyone. Here it is, the summit of Musala, the highest summit in Rila in Bulgaria on the Balkans. Close to Allah, close to God. Mus means close, and Allah the Muslim God. So the closest you can get to God around here.
The descent is refollowing our steps back to the gondola station and then riding down to Burrows, and from where our minibus will take us on the 90 minute journey to Bulgaria's capital, Sofia. Southwestern Bulgaria is dominated by two dramatic mountains, the Pirin and the equally imposing Rila. Trekking in this Balkan high country exposed us to routes almost to ourselves, with varied terrain from ancient forests, high meadows, river valleys, glacial lakes, and some good narrow ridge walking, and not forgetting celebrating being on the high summits. This, together with plenty of wildflowers and butterflies, all played its part in creating a backdrop of breathtaking, incredible scenery that, for me, will have lasting memories. Our guide Vladimir was passionate, enthusiastic, and kept us all safe and together. Managing all nine trekkers really well, he kept us informed about the region and had a story to tell about every lake and mountain, often involving a beautiful Bulgarian lady. The highlight of the trek was summiting the highest peak, Musala, the highest peak in southeastern Europe.